Good morning, everyone. How are you all doing? Hope we are keeping safe during this period and we are ensuring that we are following the appropriate guidelines given to us to keep safe. Now, today, for our subject, we'll be looking at mathematics. And the topic for today will be factors of numbers. Factors of numbers. Now we are going to look at the meaning of factors of numbers before we proceed to look at examples. Now, the factors of numbers are the numbers which you can multiply to arrive at the given number. If you are given a particular number and you are asked to look for the factors of that number, what you do, you look for all possible numbers, two numbers you can multiply to arrive at the number given. Now, first of all, let's look at the meaning of factors of numbers. Now, factors of numbers are the numbers we can multiply to get or arrive at the given number. So the factors of numbers are the numbers we can multiply to get the given number. Now, I said number in the sense here that we are looking at a particular number. For the factors of that number will be two numbers which you will multiply to arrive at that particular number. Now let's look at some examples. Now let's say find the factors of the numbers below. Find the factors of the number below. Now the first one, let's say we are given 12. Now for us to find the factors of 12, what you do, you look at two numbers which you must multiply to arrive at 12. So the first thing to do is to begin with 1. 1 times 12 will give us 12. So 1 times 12 will give us 12. Now, after you have used 1, then you move to the next line and you check if 2 can multiply a given number to arrive at 12. If 2 can multiply a given number to arrive at 12. Now, 2 times 6 is 12. So 2 times 6 are also what? Factors of 12. Then, now look at it, we started with 1, you move down to 2. Then you move to 3. But before writing it down, ask yourself, can 3 multiply any figure to give us 12? Yes, that is what? 4. So 3 times 4 will give us 12. So 3 and 4, they are also factors of 12. Now, remember, we started with 1, you move to 2, you move to 3, then you move down 4. After 3 is 4. 4 times 3 is same thing as 3 times 4, so you cannot repeat it. If you say 3 times 4 is same thing as 4 times 3, so you cannot repeat it. Therefore, 4 is empty, 4 times 3 is empty as 3 times 4. That means this is where we have to stop at. Then, therefore, we say the factors of 12 are, you start from 1, comma, you move down, 2, comma, you move down, 3, comma, after this last one, you will move to your right. You move to the right. After 3, 4, comma, they start moving up, 6, and 12. So these are the factors of 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. So these are the factors of 12. Now, let's look at example number 2. Let's say we are asked to look for the factors of 18. Factors of 18. Now, remember I said we are going to start with 1. So we have 1 times 18. It's 18. Then you move down to the next line. But before you write, after 1, you move to 2. But before you write down your 2, ask yourself, can 2 multiply any figure to give us 18? Yes, that is 9. So you say 2 times 9. 18. Then you move down. 1, 2. The next should be 3. Before you write it down, always check. Can 3 multiply any figure to give us 18? Yes, that is 6. So we have 3 times 6, 18. After 3, we have 4. Can 4 multiply any figure to give us 18? No. So you skip 4. You move down to 5. Can 5 multiply any figure to give us 18? No. So that means these are the factors of 18. So we say, therefore, the factors of 18 are, you start with 1, comma, you move downwards, comma, you move downwards, comma, then you move to your right, shift to your right, 6, then you move up, 9, and 18. So these are the factors of 18. 1, you move downwards. 2, 3, shift to your right. 6, up, 9, and 18. So these are the factors of 18. We are going to take the last example, example 3. Now, we have, let's look with factors of 21. Factors of 21. Therefore, 21, that gives us, what I said we start with? I said we only start with 1. 1. 1 multiply the given figure. 1 multiply the given figure. That's what you start with. 1 multiply the given figure that you start with. Then the next, after 1, you have 2. But before you write down your 2, check. 2 is even number. And 21 is odd number. 2 cannot multiply any figure to give you an odd number. So since we have 1 there, the next should be 2. Skip it. Why? 2 cannot multiply any figure to give you 21. Then you move to 3. Check. Can 3 multiply any figure to give you 21? Yes. That is what? 7. So we have 3 times 7. 3 times 7, 21. Then you move to 4. 4 is what? Even number. 21 is what? Odd number. So 4 cannot multiply any figure to give you 21. So we have to stop here. So we say, therefore, the factors of 21 are 1. Move down, 3. You move to your right, 7. You move up, and 21. So these are the factors of 21. These are the factors of 21. 1, 3, 7, and 21 are the factors of 21. So what we are going to do next, I will give us class work. Class work. Two class work. Thereafter, I will give us homework. Find the factors of these numbers. Number one, we have 16. And number two, we have 15. Now you find the factors of these two numbers. For your homework, so you will find the factors of these numbers below. 1, 2, 3. Factors of 20, factors of 24, and the factors of, okay, let me give ours 30. So we are going to look for the factors of 20, 24, and 30. Now, if you have issue with any of these examples, you can ask question so that I can enlighten us more on factors. Thank you.